All right, welcome back, BPD family. It is me, Big Papa D, and we're back for another one. Today, this song has been heavily requested, and there's one gentleman that requested a bunch of times, and I'll put his name, ding, right there. And it is Riley Green, and the song is Jesus Saves. All right, I look for a regular video. I think the only thing that is out right now is the lyric video to this. So it helps me because I usually have to pull up the lyrics anyhow. So this works out. I'm not sure if this is directly face value with the title or we're going to get like a storytelling and then leading to that ultimate conclusion. So without any further ado, we have Riley Green with Jesus Saves.
There was a man I used to pass on my way into town. He was covered in dirt like the world had beat him down. I often wondered how he ended up like that. So one day driving home, I pulled over to ask. I said, man, where did all go wrong? He said, son, do you really want to know?
Yeah.
My daddy left for another woman, moved off to L.A. My mama fought hard against that cancer. She died when I was 8. I finished school, my country shipped me off to war. When I came home, my whole world didn't love me anymore. It's hard to see all that when you're driving by. So I just write down Jesus Saves, cause there ain't no way I could fit that on the sign.
Wow.
I can't fit that on the sign.
I have so many things I want to say. Number one, I am naturally a curious person. When I work in big city, well, I mean, decent sized city, and I sit there in my car watching all the people go by and the hustle and bustle, and I see the people that, you know, live on the street and watch them go, and I'm always wondering what people's stories are. Honestly, my ultimate goal would be to go from city to city and just get to know people and hear their stories. Because, honestly, there's so much value in that. I never look down on anybody. Coming from a poor family and been many times in my life where I've struggled tremendously. And it's a cliche, but there for the grace of God go I. I could easily see how where my position, though I had a car and a big TV and a computer and a cell phone, I could easily see that a couple steps away, that could be me. So I've never looked down on people like that. I drive rideshare. Everything's digital. Everything's digital. But once in a while, I'll get hand tips. And every hand tip I get, I hand out to the homeless people. Because, you know, people are like, oh, don't give them money, they'll buy drugs. Well, guess what? Well, if I give them money and someone else gives them money, then they'll get drugs and food. At least they have food, you know what I'm saying? Or whatever they need. Or, I don't eat at fast food restaurants anymore because I'm doing keto and all that stuff. But, like, anytime a restaurant had to buy one, get one, I would just buy myself one, eat it, and then save the other one and hand it out. Like I said, man, I know how easy it is to fall into that trap. And then once you're to a place and you have no one, you have no family. You know how many times my family's picked me up over the years? And vice versa, I've picked family members up. And if you don't have that safety net, man, it's so easy. It's so freaking easy, man. this is gonna kill me. This is something that's true, you know, near and dear to my heart, and I think about what people are going through and this kind of stuff, and man, I'm very empathetic. I'm a very empathetic person, and all right, I'm actually happy this isn't a video, because I'd definitely be crying by now if it was.
I can't fit that on the sign. I took him to a diner. I bought him a cup of coffee. He asked me if he could bum a couple dollars off me. He told me his story, I told mine. He said thanks, cause most folks around here would never take the time. He said, I lost my job down at the mill when that factory closed. Army stopped sending me them checks. The bank took everything I own. Hitchhiked my way up to Chicago. The nights were too damn cold. I hopped a train headed west, cause I had nowhere else to go. It's hard to see all that driving by. So I just write down Jesus saved, cause there ain't no way I could fit that on a sign.
You know, people like, when they see homeless people asking for money, they're like, oh, get a job, bum, get a job, bum. You stand outside for 12 hours in the rain, the cold, everything, and then you get dirty looks. And 99.9% of the people don't pay you the time of day. And how soul-crushing that is. And just how embarrassing it is. And you think that they would be out there if... Man, it's just... It crushes me, man. Absolutely freaking crushes me. I'm not going to talk about my experiences. I've done things. But I'm not here to get, you know... I'm not virtue sick. I'm not here to earn, you know... any kind of currency. But it just crushes my soul, man, because there's so many people out there that just, people just treat, we treat each other so freaking terribly, man. And just think, you gotta think if it was you or someone you know or someone you love. Dude, a guy, I have to say, tell this story, because this dude I grew up with, he went to school. One day when I was in third or fourth grade, I was getting beat up by a bunch of bullies. I was a real tiny kid. And this dude come over and kicked some butt, and he saved me. And he said, he picked me up, and he was like, as long as I'm here, they're never going to hurt you again. You're a good kid. And, you know, it's not fair. They're messing with you. And I remembered that. Come 30, 40 years later, well, yeah, probably about, yeah, 30, 35 years later, I'm on Facebook, and I see him. He was very successful out in Vegas. And I remember just hearing stories about how well he was doing. Well, guess what? He had it all. And things just come crushing down. He lost his beautiful house and lost his family. And he was living in his van. And really down and out and depressed. And this guy's one of the best musicians I've ever heard from in my life. Beautiful on the piano. Could play everything from classical to modern stuff. Very nice guy. Very talented. Very intelligent. And if that can happen to that guy, it can happen to freaking anybody. He was having so much trouble. And I don't have money. But I sent him what little bit I had and said, brother, I'll give you everything I can. Because you were... He was very important in my life, because it made me know that, you know, there was people out there looking out for me. People appreciated who I was. It makes you cry and think about it. And the fact that I reached out to him, wrote him a long letter and sent him that money, it turned his shit around. It turned him around. He got his stuff together, collected what he could, sold what he could, got in that van, and he got back home to here. Because in this town... Everyone here loves this guy, because like I say, he's a great guy. He got here, and he's back on his feet. He's doing well. He's met a girl. They live in a nice house. And it's like, just that one he gave me a moment of kindness. And then I returned that moment. And it changed both of our lives. Seriously. I mean, I would have been that kid that was just depressed because I was always getting messed with. And who knows where I would have went or what would have happened or what kind of group I would have fell in with. And if I didn't reach out to him there, I mean, he could have been down on the streets eventually or went down the drug route or whatever. And it's just those small, you don't know what they're going to do, man. The small acts of kindness can really make a freaking difference. I'm sorry, man, but this is, like I said, when it started, I knew this was going to be this way for me. So let me back it up.
So I just write down Jesus saved, because there ain't no way I could fit that on a sign. There ain't no way to fit that on. Probably would have wrote down a little more if I could have found a bigger piece of cardboard. My brother Walter was my hero, but he was bad to drink. One night he laid his Harley down near that Ohio river bank.
Right,
me
on
and my
river
ex-wife
bank.
Tried for kids and we were dating. Yeah, we even had baby names picked out, but little Walter didn't make it. It's hard to see all that driving by. So I just write down Jesus saves, cause there ain't no way I could fit that on a sign.
And everyone has those stories.
I can't fit all that on a sign.
Everyone you know has those kind of stories. And the world is so damn judgmental of people. I mean, I developed a long time ago. I just stopped caring what people thought about me. And I know I'm a good person. I know I have good morals. I know I live my life in the best way I possibly can. But people are so mean and judgmental and selfish and... It's a damn shame. Because like I said, everyone has that kind of story, man. Everyone has terrible things that have happened to them. And like I said, like there's not a sign letting you know that. But just think about it. Think about your life. Think about your friends and family's lives. People are like, oh, they're lazy. Or, you know, they just don't want to work or whatever. It's like, you don't get there, man, without something crazy happening. And I don't, when I say crazy, I'm not, you know, doubting on mental health or anything. I'm just saying without a terrible series of events. And you got to look back in your life. If you lived a blessed life where you never had anything terrible happen to you, then God bless you. Because you're a lucky son of a bitch. But, man, this really got me. It's a beautiful song. Great sentiment. I never look down on anybody, man. Like I said, I have had jobs where I've sat in the ritziest places, dining with millionaires. And then I've also hung out in freaking alleys drinking 40s, or underneath the bridge drinking 40 ounces with, you know, whoever. People are people. I get along wherever I'm at, because I genuinely care about people and stuff like that. You gotta do better, world. You gotta do better. I appreciate the suggestion. Really got me. This is personal to me. Oh, man. Anything, Riley Green stuff will be, I just like lost all train of thought. Riley stuff will be in the description. Make sure you click on the video, like, subscribe his channel. Check out what he's going on. My stuff will be there, too. Anything else from Riley you want me to do, let me know in the comments. We have four channels here. This is the country channel, my main channel, the rap channel, and my podcast channel. If you're not subscribed to one or all those, please do. I appreciate you all very, very much. You will see me again. Peace and love.
Can't believe you're still here. Did you fall asleep? If you like this video, I suggest you subscribe and or seek professional help. Your choice.